Welcome to Microsoft Unboxed. Every week, we are diving into great stories about Microsoft technology and the people behind them. My name's Colleen O'Brien. I'm one of your co-hosts, and I'm here with my friend and colleague, Sonia Dara.
Hello.
You're gonna tell me a story that I've never heard before, and I'm going to share one with you. This week's topic is tech in retail.
Cha-ching! What has been your latest shopping spree?
To be honest, I use technology for all of my shopping. I don't even go to the grocery store anymore.
Grocery store even?
I like use an app to get my groceries delivered. And it's great because you can do your meal planning and it's not dependent on what's there in the grocery store.
It takes like 45 minutes to get to the closest grocery store.
It is a 30 flight hike to get to the grocery store.
Yeah. I've shifted more to online shopping, trying to still get out of fast fashion. For those of you who don't know, fast fashion is one of the biggest culprits for textile waste. Trying to get more into like things that will last a little bit longer, and so buy three sizes and what I don't like, I return.
It's called the slow clothes movement.
Slow clothes movement.
What makes technology really great here is that you can spend a long time researching, making sure you're getting the right thing.
Sustainable materials, textiles.
Right.
But there's still some things like jean shopping I need to just go do in person.
You do have to try on some jeans, but spoiler alert, I have some information for you.
Sweet! For a 6 foot tall girl.
Yeah, they're not discriminating with their technology. My technology and retail story is about Gap Inc. and how they're doubling down on both their online experience and their in-person experience. Gap is a customer of ours, which is why we're so up to speed on all of these technology investments. And one of the products that they're leveraging is Azure. They're consolidating all of their legacy systems and migrating hundreds of apps over to Azure because they want to take advantage of the elasticity of the cloud platform. Picture this. It's Black Friday. You want to take advantage of this really great deal, but because so many people are hitting the same website at once, you can't get the item. Because they're migrating their systems to Azure, Azure has this elasticity to make sure when their web traffic spikes on, say, a Black Friday, that their website will be available for everyone who wants access to that deal at the same time.
So I don't have to like camp out for like 4 days now to like shove in front of people for Black Friday?
Absolutely not. Stay in your Snuggie, make a turkey sandwich, just hop online and you will get those deals.
How do you know I have a Snuggie?
Doesn't everyone?
A gravity blanket Snuggie?
Gravity Snuggie? I'm sure they're developing that.
We had the idea here first. Don't take it.
If you do happen to get out of bed on Black Friday, you will probably be pleasantly surprised by a lot of the technology investments that brick and mortar stores like Gap are making. The first thing that was really exciting to me to read about are these tech-enabled fitting rooms.
That actually reminds me, there's a company we partnered up with for the launch of Surface Go called Finery. If you've seen Clueless, which of course everyone, if you haven't watched Clueless yet, like after after this video, go watch Clueless. But you know how she like goes through and it digitizes her closet, essentially. Mm-hmm. Finery is doing that, where essentially scanning basically all your receipts that you have from previous purchases to actually help you understand what's currently in your wardrobe. It saves you time, saves you money, so you don't have to go out and buy new stuff that you actually might already have. Mm. So then it also gives you inspiration for new fashion ideas, things that you can use to complement what you already have, and it's just a really cool technology placed upon something existing in your closet. Maybe that's what Gap's gonna do.
They're also thinking about AI-assisted styling. Ooh. So like if you wear these pants, what shirt should you wear with it? They're gonna do geo-targeted offers through mobile. So maybe you walk into a store and it's like, hey, we see that you're here, we see that you're a loyal Gap customer. Here is a coupon
or a little reward system for coming in person and putting on real lady pants and not
real lady pants.
But when you're trying to put on real world pants and not like pajamas,
I call them my house pants.
I guess mine are house pants too.
Like as soon as you get home, you put on your house pants.
Do you leave your house with your house pants still on?
I try not to, but they sneak out every once in a while.
For that hike up to the grocery store, apparently not.
Just to take the compost out.
That's so Seattle. Maybe you'll get new house pants.
That's the dream.
Whether you prefer to stay home in your house pants and do some online shopping, or you're wearing your house pants out
in public,
retail companies are making these really interesting and awesome investments to make the experience even better.
I'm going to talk about a startup that is helping these brick and mortar stores get people out of their house pants into their stores. The startup is called DogSpot. DogSpot is actually using technology to build dog houses outside of brick and mortar stores to help keep your dog safe while you go shop. There's a lot of stores that don't allow little puppies in, and you have to tie them up outside. And so maybe it's really bad weather, maybe it's super hot and you have to leave them in the car and you're worried about the window. Someone can steal your dog. Apparently dog theft is on the rise, like terrible people out there that will actually steal a dog. There are these dog houses outside of these stores. They're temperature controlled, and then the front door is shatterproof glass.
Okay, got it.
The dog can still see out, but it can breathe. It has air conditioning.
It has air conditioning?
Yes.
I don't even have air conditioning in my home. I might like to try one out.
I know, especially in the summer when it's like super
hot. There's no air conditioning in Seattle.
The whole point is you don't want your dog like sitting out in like freezing rain or anything. So
right. They
call it Smart Sidewalk Sanctuaries. How's that for alliteration and a tongue twister?
I love it.
Smart Sidewalk Sanctuaries.
Smart Sidewalk Sanctuaries.
Originally funded through Microsoft for Startups. So you download the app, you get access to it for up to 90 minutes. You can monitor your dog on your phone. It has a camera inside, so you can see how your dog's doing. It's self-cleaning afterwards. They'll have some people come in for like little accidents. One of the cooler things for the brick and mortar stores that are sponsoring this, they noticed 48% of users switched where they actually shop.
Wow.
Because of where these dog spots were available.
As a former dog owner, I would always do research, like, is the place that I'm about to go dog friendly? If not, where can I find a dog friendly version of this?
Exactly. And then 40% have gone to a store because there was a dog spot there.
That's amazing.
So like they're walking across the street, they see a dog spot, they're like, ooh, that's interesting. They might not even have a dog, but they will go to a store. Just cool technology to place in that makes it so much easier for people to take off their house pants and get into a store and make sure their dog's safe at the same time.
Yeah, it's like a little attraction for people to visit now.
A little smart sidewalk sanctuary.
Whether it's this incredible innovation that's happening at brick and mortar shops like dog spot or these more intelligent dressing rooms, there are such amazing advancements that are happening at this intersection of retail and technology.
How about we move into outside the box, Colleen?
Great transition. You're gonna have 30 seconds to answer this question. You ready for it?
No.
What is the craziest fashion trend you ever rocked?
It has to be from the 90s.
Of course.
It was the butterfly clips.
Loved those.
The bell bottoms. The biggest culprit was the t-shirts that you wore on top of a long sleeve white shirt.
Oh, yeah.
It was like limited too. Yeah, doubled up. Overalls too. There's some overalls.
There are like fashion overalls now.
Now, but back then it was just like kind of unfortunate, and I had like a bowl cut to go along with it. It was just a bad combo. It was bad.
All right, time's up.
All right.
I'm ready.
What was your favorite item of clothing as a kid?
Remember before leggings, they were just stretch pants? These were like leggings, but just stretchy pants, and then they had the stirrups at the bottom.
Oh, yeah, yeah, yeah.
I had a pair of black and white striped ones that I wore with everything, even if it didn't really match what I was wearing.
Like with dresses on top?
Oh, yeah. Anything and everything.
That's funny that we both got clothing-related things, and there's so many questions in here, but we both got clothing things for our retail episode.
The universe is aligning.
The box knows all.
If you want to submit questions for Outside the Box, do so at the email address below or comment on this video.
Make sure you subscribe to this show, so click on the button. We'll have a new episode every Thursday, so make sure you tune in. Thanks for coming today.
Over and out.
Thanks for coming today. Thanks for tuning in today.
Hey everyone, if you can't get enough of us, I would highly recommend subscribing to our podcast, Women in Business and Technology, available right here.
And you can follow us on Twitter and Instagram at our social handles right here.